Good evening, YouTube. This is jewel weed or spotted touch me not. It is supposedly the only cure for poison ivy. I'm not bothered by poison ivy, but probably nice to have some of the cure preserved kicking around for the times of year when this stuff is not actually growing. So what we're going to do is pull out all of the plants. Strip the leaves off as chop and drop mulch for the brassicas here. But don't. Roots off for the compost and repeat.
All alone on this lonesome trail.
I have never actually done this before, making of the tincture for storage. I have made tinctures for immediate use many times for people suffering from poison ivy, and well, a tincture is made with alcohol, and urushiol, the I think that's what it's called, the chemical that causes the blisters in poison ivy, is oil soluble. Washing something that is oil-based with alcohol is always a good way to get rid of it anyway, whether or not the jewelweed is an effective cure or not. So we're going to take this stuff in the house and whiz it up in the blender and put it to steep in some rubbing alcohol.
Stop or pause.
Okay. As you can see, we're in the kitchen. RevToast TV has just made that the funniest thing said on YouTube for myself and many of his subscribers. So we're going to start by chopping this up some. Alcohol. This particular brand is camphorated methyl alcohol, but it's only 50%. I would prefer to be using a 70 or a 90, even if it was isopropyl.
Who needs to use the sink?
Just hand me a paper towel. A
little bit worse.
So, as this is not food grade alcohol, I'm using the glass blender. If it was food grade, I would have used the Ninja, which is much better at shredding things to nothingness. Try this. I highly suggest that you make certain before you start into all this heavy chopping that you're not actually allergic to jewel weed. Take a piece of the stem, crush it slightly, and rub it on somewhere where it's not going to kill you if you get an allergic reaction. Just because one person is not allergic to something doesn't mean that you aren't. Just because one person is allergic to something doesn't mean that you are. Poison ivy is basically an allergic reaction. And it's something that I actually don't react to. I was out 2 weeks ago with my neighbor building a new pasture for his cattle. 2 days working waist deep in poison ivy, putting in fence posts, dumping fence posts in the poison ivy, then picking them up and carrying them around on my shoulder from hole to hole. And all I got was one little blister on my forearm that was there for 3 days and gone. Mind you, I was born with asthma and eczema. Poison ivy isn't itchy if you spent your life with eczema. So, this is going to be set someplace dark to percolate for a few weeks, a few months, a year. Depends. There's air bubbles in it. I'm just trying to get them to rise to the surface. And when that is done, what we're going to do I have a jar full of tincture of wormwood that I started about this time last year, and it's made with vodka. This is actually one of the flavorings used to make absinthe. So we will be doing exactly the same procedure to the tincture of jewel weed. Bring it in a very fine mesh bag. This whole thing started as a result of a discussion with another mead maker. on the possibility of making an absinthe mead. Okay, this is about 600 milliliters.
330 milliliters. I believe that's 500 milliliters.
That is a 750 milliliter jar.
My absolute favorite non-homemade barbecue sauce. If you ever find it, it's worth a try. No, that's my second favorite. The other one is Cattle Men. They have a habanero and a something else.
So now that is ready to be labeled and put into storage. It is, I don't know, more than 50% alcohol. No. It was made with vodka, so the vodka would be 40% alcohol. So it's more than 30% alcohol, so it doesn't need anything to keep it good. Although we will keep it in the refrigerator downstairs. That's the process. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.